Hello everybody, welcome to Kingdom of Learning. So in this video I'm going to explain the chapter The Making of a Scientist, which is chapter 6 of the book Footprints Without Feet of class 10th. So actually this is written by Robert W. Peterson, and this is not a story or fictitious work, rather it actually tells about the story of the making of a real scientist. Means we come to know about the real life of a real scientist whose name was Richard Ebright. So actually Richard Ebright became a great scientist, and how did he become that scientist, that is all given in this chapter. So it is told to us that Richard Ebright's father died very young, so he was living alone with his mother in Pennsylvania, and when he was living there he didn't have many friends, and that's why he used to spend most of his time in watching the butterflies. Means he had great fascination for watching the butterflies, and he used to collect so many butterflies and he used to watch them develop and all these things. And the real force behind making him a scientist was his mother. And Richard Ebright collected 25 varieties of butterflies, and then his mother bought him a book. The name of that book was The Travels of Monarch 10. The Monarch 10 is the type of a butterfly, and this book opened a new world of science for Richard. Means he got so much interested in the lives of butterflies and all these things after reading this book. So he read in this book actually that there are some types of butterflies, monarch butterflies and viceroy butterflies. So he found that he read in this book that the viceroy butterflies, they taste good to the birds, and monarch butterflies, they are not so tasty to the birds, so birds do not eat them. So just to avoid the birds to be the food of the birds, viceroy butterflies, they copied monarch butterflies. So he read about these things, and then at the last of that book, Monarch, The Travels of Monarch 10, there was a message from the writer of that book. The writer of that book was Dr. Urquhart. And he had written a message that whosoever is interested in collecting the butterflies, you tag them, put a tag on the wing of that butterfly with some adhesive or something, and you send these butterflies to me in America and I will collect them. So now Richard Ebright started doing the same thing. He started keeping the butterflies in the basement of his house, and he looked after them. He saw the whole life cycle of the butterflies, and then he would send them to Dr. Urquhart. But later on he found that this was a very tedious task. He got bored of this and he stopped that work. But this after this he started doing some real life experiments. So when he was in 7th grade at his school, he made one project, and that was project means he neatly displayed the life of a frog, and he didn't get any prize. So he felt very bad, and then he observed the prizes of those students who had got the means he observed the projects of those students who had got the prizes, and he came to know that actually those students got the prize who had tried to show something new. Means not only neatly displaying something already been discovered is going to get prize. So he found this thing, and he in 8th grade now he made a project on some viral disease that kills the butterflies. So although he couldn't prove his point, but still he got some prize and he got appreciation also. So in this way every year he went on progressing. He made new projects, and gradually his project started getting selected. And when he was in the second year of his college, his project got selected for the National Science Fair, and that was a project of science fair project was testing the theory that viceroy butterflies copy monarch. So this project he had made, means actually he had read in the book that viceroy butterflies copy monarch butterflies, but he made a project in which he showed that some monarch butterflies were also eaten by the birds. So he proved that theory wrong. So in this way he got selected. So now after that Richard Ebright had all the ingredients for making of a scientist. Means he was very inquisitive from the beginning of his life. He had that curiosity to do research on new things, and he was an observer, he was a thinker, and he was a very hard working person. And then he means he had lot of interest in making new researches and all these things. So actually he made so many new discoveries, new projects. And when he was in the second year of his college, he studied the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spots on a monarch pupa. Means he found that there were some 12 golden spots on the wings of monarch pupa. Earlier it was believed that they were only because of beautifying the wings, means they were just ornamental. But Richard Ebright proved this thing, that actually they were the DNA of that butterfly. Means he took only those gold spots and he kept them in the lab, and he means he proved that they could create a new butterfly. Only those gold spots, they were not only ornamental, rather they consisted of the DNA of the butterfly. So this was a big project of Richard Ebright. And now during his junior years, he got the idea of new theory about cell life. He was looking at X-ray photos of the chemical structure of a hormone, and seeing the photos, he believed that the photos gave him the answer to the puzzle, how the cells can read the blueprint of its DNA. So in this way, the small study, means just a study that was just for fun, study of the butterflies, led to the study of human cells and DNA. So finally that student, means Richard Ebright, became a big scientist later on in his life, and now he is known as the scientist who has done lot of work in the field of cancer and DNA and all these things. And here his mother and Dr. Urquhart played a big role in making of this scientist. Apart from his own keen interest and his hard work and his curiosity and all these things. And at last the writer tells us that he was not only interested in science, rather he was a big, means he was a great orator also. He had lot of interest in canoeing, canoist. He was a canoeist, means he was fond of boating also. He was a good speaker also, and he was a great debater also. So all these things proved to make him a great scientist. So here I want to end this chapter. I hope all the details have been provided to you. So you can ask anything if you are doubtful in the comment box. So keep on watching my other videos also, and do subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Thank you.